Ladies and gentlemen, you're here on the Music Workshop. Right now, we're going to kick it off with Matthew Yates.
We'll be right back. my face. Wanna hear the funky bass? Put a smile on my face. Wanna hear the funky bass? Put a smile on my face. Wanna hear the funky bass? Put a smile on my face. I'm
I want to be free.
Yeah. We'll be right back. Hands now. Let the damned water be. There's some people down the way that's thirsty, so let the liquid spirit free. The people are thirsty cause a man's unnatural hand. Watch what happens when the people catch wind, when the water hit the banks of that hard dry land. Liquid spirit, liquid spirit, liquid spirit, liquid spirit. Clap your hands now. Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was my guy, Matthew Yates. Matthew, thank you very much for coming out on the Music Workshop today, for coming out here and throwing down and doing what you do best, my brother. Mm-hmm. I was telling Jerry that you are jamming out, and he said that that's what you always do.
Yes, sir. Yes,
so,
sir.
So, you know, for the past 20 years or so.
Yes, sir.
Let's get accurate and get it from the horse's mouth. Matthew, how long have you been DJing?
I've been spinning since 1981.
1981. And you also produce.
Yes,
you
sir.
You produce several tunes already,
yes, sir.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And when did you start producing that?
I started actually producing, within the last, 6 years.
Okay.
I was making records with Stacy Kidd. Stacy Kidd kind of opened the doors.
Okay.
And everything kicked off for me.
Good old Stacy.
2002.
Yeah. Okay.
2001.
So, here, because you've got more seniority on the decks, 81. Mm-hmm. Back then, who were your actual idols or people that you look up to when you're DJing?
Wow. I can honestly say Farley Jack Master Funk. With the Saturday Night Live Ain't No Jive Chicago Dance
yeah.
Party. Actually, the entire Hot Mix 5 was great. And I used to just stay up late to hear some of the more soulful disco type styles.
Yes, those came in later at night.
Later in the night.
More
yeah.
earlier at 10 o'clock, they
yeah.
came in with the hard house. You're right, you're right.
It was more hard
right.
house and then once it got, 10 o'clock.
Yeah,
hour,
then
11,
it got
12.
Deeper.
Yeah, and it
okay.
got deeper as the night went on, yeah.
And I was more into the harder one.
Yeah.
But now, as the years go by, it's like, wow, you know, mm-hmm. I kind of wish that was available again, you know?
Yeah, yeah, so, all the time.
The whole evolving of into from the hard baby house to the grown folks, mm-hmm. Deep house and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
How many tracks have you produced so far?
Oh wow, over 180. Well, I'm gonna say about just over 100, maybe about 130, 120 tracks.
Okay.
Since High Fidelity kicked off through Kingdom Digital Music, it's like I got control over pretty much everything I do. That's what I was longing for, you know what I mean? Even when I was singing, you know, the I Wanted You and Feel the Power, you know, I've always wanted to be on the production side of it. And the track making, I got to thank my guy, go by the name of DJ Rampage back then. He's known as Skagnitty today.
Uh-huh.
He actually opened the door for production, showed me how to make my first tracks. Back on Morgan Park, man, on 119th Street and Low, man. Low Street guys, what's up?
what were you back then? What were you functioning with? What were you making tracks with?
Wow, man, that was like the we can say the four track mixers, and we would bounce them down, and you know he would show me how to, mostly leave the drums on the outside because everything was on tape, you know, so. We would lay bass on the outside of the tape, uh-huh. and toward the middle it would be more of the melody and the strings, but mostly the bass would be on the outside, and we would bounce them down and two tracks, and then we would add more tracks as the project progressed. So mad love to Skagnitty.
Yeah, now it's all computerized and whatnot,
yeah.
and you know we got it better. What can I say?
Hey, I can't complain. I can't complain. It's the computer deal, man, I just, you know, computers is my thing. The main thing about computers, I wanted to learn how they work first before I got off into producing and making tracks, or even DJing, you know, because if there's a problem going on, I don't want the crowd to know. You got to know exactly what to do in case there is a problem, and backup is very important. That is very important. Whatever you do on a computer, man, make sure you back it up, whether it's songs or tracks, whatever you do, backup is very important.
And what are you working on now?
Currently, got a lot of guys from South Africa. I'm going to give it up one time for Lifa Linka. Started a label for him called Deep Rooted Invasions. I have Salad Interno High Fidelity Productions, keeping him current, Boss Williams. Right now, I just finished a project not too long ago for Emmanuel Christian Inaro, and called My House. Just hit the streets a couple of days ago, and So mad love to Mario, Manuel. I'm sorry, Emmanuel Christian Inaro. I want also want to give it up to Mr. Smith the second. Doggone it. Can't think of his name. Just played the record in the mix. I'm kind of, you know, but these are Son of KC and Sunshine Band. But right now, trying to get some, I got several tracks in the wings. And, you know, you're trying to do two and three productions at one time. You bounce from one to the other. So I got another one called My House. I have to change it now that they dropped that one.
Oh, wow.
So I'm glad I didn't drop it because they come with that one. I didn't want them to clash like that. Yeah.
And any residencies?
At one point, yes, it was. I DJed in several different clubs, and it would be great to have a house residency. Most of the time I was in the club, it was more on the adult steppers and stuff like that. It was kind of hard. When I was doing the club scene, it was kind of hard to get the house music in the clubs. Right now, all the clubs want it, you know. But it would be great to be, you know, in a residency, you know, if you know, time permits, the Lord say the same.
Yeah. I hear you and I believe you. So where can the audience hear more of Matthew Yates? What do you got going here?
Okay.
SoundClouds to who knows what. To,
yeah, SoundCloud, a lot of mixes on MixCloud. You can also check me out every Tuesday on Only One FM, Chicago Takeover Tuesdays at 6 p.m. Central, 7 Eastern. I just talked to Stump Radio just this morning about setting up another show with him on the daytime side where it's nighttime there in the UK. And also give it up one time for Philly Nights Radio. I'm on their station every Saturday between 7 and 8 o'clock. And you can hear me regular on PhillyNightsRadio.com.
That's awesome. That is awesome. And now soon he'll be on the on our YouTube from the Music Workshop. And we'll have that out.
Hey, I really appreciate you guys having me, man. This is awesome, man.
No,
you guys...
it's like I said, like I keep saying, and I don't want to sound like a broken record. We're here to show the world that we have some excellent talent in Chicago.
Yes, yes.
And with your cooperation and being a part of this, we thank you.
I really appreciate
it. I want to thank Jerry as well because he, you know, him and a few others have put their heads together to try to, you know, push the movement.
Yes.
You know,
and
because we're not all, Chicago's not as bad as they make us out to be. There's a lot of goodness here, and that's
yes,
what we want to represent here.
Yes, it is.
And that's, you know.
One thing I've always said throughout the years, man, there is definitely enough for everybody. You know, whatever, you know, however long you've been doing it, nothing can be taken away from you. You know what I mean? You know, from the big wigs all the way down to, you know what I mean, to the DJs in their bedroom. You know, if you've been doing it a long time and you're out there in the limelight, man, and someone like me come along and want to play, believe me, you'll still be where you are. There's nothing, you know, that's a, it seems like, it seems like some of our DJs are threatened by other DJs, but that's not the case, man. If you're holding a spot, believe me, you won't lose it. Your people love you, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, if you do your job right, and you just, your heart is out there, you're right, you're gonna hold that down. A lot of DJs are threatened, and there are other DJs that are thirsty, and it's sad, but I mean, step at a time, just continue to do what you do. But anyways, No. This ain't about me giving anybody advice. What advice? What would you tell these new DJs that are out there starting off right now?
Well, the main thing I would tell a man, stay humble. Never blow out anyone else's candle so that yours will be brighter. Never do that. It can honestly hinder you more than help you. That's one thing I never, ever wanted to do. I believe that I'm put here to help somebody, you know, because there was, I remember back in the 80s, you know, when I first ran into Farley and I wanted to do records then. And he gave me the okay, but he never came back for me, but I never held it against him, you know, because I knew he was a busy man. You know, he was... probably traveling. He was probably doing more things than I could ever imagine at that time, you know, because he was, you know, he's still at his peak, but he was really, really booming. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Farley was, even me as a kid, that was one of my favorites. I would just, you know, Farley, you know, I've said this many times before, because of the radio and being too young to go to a club, I never knew Farley was black.
Wow.
Okay? And that's just, this is the power of music and radio and whatnot, and I was able to just, you know, this guy, just his music, everything that he played, it moved Chicago.
Yeah.
It moved a lot. It influenced a lot of us today that are still DJing. Like I said, not that it would have changed anything of him being black or Asian or whatever.
But I didn't know either.
I didn't know he was black. Why? Because I don't have technology like today where we can see who's DJing. You just hear it. And like I said, we all had bags over our heads. So house music did a lot. It impacted a lot of people.
Yes.
The genre was actually heard in many parts, many suburbs, many all over Chicago. And it, to me, that was kind of like the one thing that we all had in common, regardless of what nationality you were. So, and house music is still here today. People used to tell me, that's going to die, that's going to die. Breakdancing is coming through, blah, blah, blah. I tell you what. House music is still here.
Yeah.
Breakdancing
It'll never die. It'll never die. As long as me and Jerry just talking earlier, as long as we kind of embrace the youth, you know, and I heard that Steve Miggity was teaching a lot of kids, you know, house music. I believe maybe he's teaching them production. I think that's a great thing. That's something that I've always wanted to do, you know, inspire someone else to get, you know, in the field, you know, or get the chances that I never got. You know, and there are so many out there that wants to do it.
Yeah, that's awesome. Steve teaches Logic. That's awesome.
That's awesome. And I think that's something I wanted to do. You know, show, you know, whether it's Logic or Cakewalk or Pro Tools, whatever. I mostly run Cakewalk, Ableton Live, and I also use SoundForge sometimes for editing. But you know, these different programs. I think it'd be great, you know, it'll get a lot of these kids, you know, into something and not have so much time for, you know, crap that's going on out there, you know. I really truly believe in helping others, man. I think that's the best thing. I think that's what I'm put here for, really. That's why I reached out to the guys in South Africa, man, and Lifa Linka, and I want to give it up to Lifa Linka and the DRI movement. Those guys are really putting in the work, and I'm going to see to it that, you know, everything gets where it's supposed to go and make sure that they get what's coming to them as well. Oh, yeah, I want to give it up. Ron Lewis Smith II. That's the My House joint.
That was the song you were talking about.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to think
of. Well, we don't want to, well, we would like not to cut it short, but before we leave this, who would you like to give out your powerful shout-outs to?
Oh, wow. Well, say big ups to Ron Lewis Smith II, Emmanuel Christian Inaro. I want to give it up to all my listeners of Only One FM. I thank you for the weekly tune-ins. Roscoe Jam and Johnson, Boss Williams. Want to give it up to the one and only Nay. My sweetheart, LJ, always by my side every step of the way. What would I do without her? That's Arthur Johnson, Damian Goods. It's just so many. Light Up King in Florida. I mean, I'm not Florida. He's in California. The guy bounces around. One time for Light Up King. And the original High Fidelity members, DJ Clever Clear, Arthur, and DJ Clever Clear and Donnie Disco, doing some great things in the streets. Donnie is bouncing around everywhere, banging house music everywhere. And mad love to the Kingdom Digital Music Group. Jerry opened some doors that has never been opened, that I think should have been opened maybe 10, 15 years ago, but it's never too late. It's always on time, so don't think you, maybe it might not have been meant for me at the time, you know what I'm saying? So big ups to Jerry, and I thank him for opening the doors, and not only that, man, it's so much going on that, you know, my peers wouldn't believe that I have the key to, you know, actually help them get started if they want to.
Right, right. You know, and that is awesome. Jerry, you know, he's always out there just scouting and helping and you know, he's thrown so many coins at me and, you know, just being so busy, sometimes we don't pick up those coins and make use of them.
Mm-hmm.
But time will come where I'll have to say, hey, man, these are too many coins, and I'm going to grab them coins and put them to use. Because he means well, and, you know, how can you, you know,
yeah,
not
you overlook
take
it?
To use to something, right. Someone trying to help you out, doesn't have to help you out.
And
so that's awesome.
This big event coming on the 22nd is just phenomenal. You know.
Yes, don't miss that event. We shall be there. Ooh,
don't miss that. That is going to be off the chain. Down
move your
at
body.
The at the Move Your Body Millennium Park on the 22nd. I guarantee there's going to be a stone gas.
The Pritzker.
Yeah,
whatever that is. Yeah,
you know the Millennium Park. Everybody knows the big silver bean. Uh-huh. You know where the Frankie Knuckles tribute took place. So it's going to be really, really large. So
don't miss it this Friday, guys.
Don't miss it.
Yeah,
it's going to be off the chain.
Hey, man, Matthew Yates, thank you very much for coming out
thank
here, man.
Thank you so much, Money. Thank you, brother. I thank you guys for having me.
Don't leave yet, guys. We're gonna continue on and do an interview with Kim J. So please stay tuned. Again. Have a blessed one.
Love
Ray,
you.
Ray, take it away.